Walk along and sing the song. Hello, Maltese. Magnificentos. Ralphie here. And I just did review number 47, I think it was. So this will be review 48, where I recommend five single malts, which are generally available and at a reasonable, well, reasonable-ish price. So I've put them in order, going from light to heavy. A wee topical tip, when you're enjoying your single malt whiskies or even your blends, never start with a heavy peaty whiskey and then think that you can go back to lighter whiskies, more delicate whiskies, because as you go back to these lighter, more delicate whiskies, you find that all you taste is the peat from your previous Islay peated malt. And it's amazing when I go to whiskey shows, I see people rush through the door and go straight to the first malt they can find. And it happens to be from Islay. It could be Laphroaig, which is an absolute killer. And they get themselves a glass of Laphroaig, and then they go to somewhere like Bunahabhain, somewhere like Pulteney, Auchentoshan, Glenfiddich, and they really can't taste the whiskey in the glass anymore. At whiskey shows, or whether you're sitting down at home or out with your pals, start with the lighter whiskies and then go up to the heavier whiskies. And therefore, by doing that, you'll get the benefit of the smell and of the taste, and ultimately, that's what you're paying for and why you're not just guzzling back vodka. Starting with Pulteney. Old Pulteney, the most northerly distillery on the Scottish mainland, northeast Scotland, consistently magnificent at 12 years old, and very much adhering to a craft tradition. Not a picture postcard distillery, but very much a picture postcard malt. Highly recommended, wonderfully complex. Next, Glenmorangie. Glenmorangie, the tallest stills in Scotland. And because they have such tall stills, the vapour coming off the wash, rising up these stills, there's a lot of reflux, a lot of cloud activity going on, and results in a complex, fine-flavoured and very engaging whisky. Next, now this is probably the least available of my selection, but hunt out if you can, Ben Nevis. Ben Nevis Distillery is a medium-sized distillery where most of the whisky goes over to Japan to help them out over there. It tends to be off the radar a little bit, tends to be overlooked. If you ever see a bottle on the shelves at your shops, buy it and try it. It's good stuff. It's what you call a beefy West Coast Highlander of a substantial character. Next is our cask strength whisky from Speyside. We've got to give Speyside a mention, after all the majority of stills are in Speyside. And it's Aberlour Abernah. Wee bit pricier than your average malt, but it is a cask strength. It's in excess of 60% alcohol. I mean, if you're in the US, that's over 120 proof. So definitely going to add the water to this. A good, robust whisky. And now we will conclude on Islay. Obvious choice, really. Ardbeg 10-year-old. Ardbeg, at the moment, apart from being outrageously overhyped as a collector's item, simply because of the intrinsic quality of the malt and the fact that it's bottled a little bit higher strength and not chill filtered. Hint, hint, Mr. Distillers. Very much one to be recommended. So enjoy, and I'll see you soon, where I'll recommend some of the more expensive whiskies.